Hello everyone. Today we are going to do a question on dimensional analysis. Dimensional analysis is a very important tool in physics in order to find the consistency of a given equation. Also, it can be used to find the relationship between different physical quantities. But it should be kept in mind that dimensional analysis cannot give exact equation. So let's see the question. Here, the air bubble formed by explosion inside water performs oscillations with time period capital T, which depends on pressure capital P and density rho and the energy due to explosion E. So we need to establish the relationship between time period, pressure, energy and density. So when you are given a question in this way, first write what is given in the equation. So what is given in the equation? Here time period is dependent upon, so time period capital T is dependent upon, what are the number one, pressure. So write pressure, then number two, density. So write density. Number three, energy. Write energy. So these are the things given in the question. Time period depends upon pressure P, density rho and energy capital E. But how it is dependent? It's not given. The relationship not given. So in this case, write this way. T, time period proportional to pressure raised to the power A. A is some arbitrary constant. Then rho raised to the power B. Then E raised to the power C. Okay, so when the question is given, write the given terms. Okay, the terms which are dependent, the terms which are dependent are should be written on the left side, and the things on which the left side terms are dependent upon should be written on the right side, raised to some arbitrary constants A, B and C. So to make it an equation, let's write T is equal to K, P to the power A, rho to the power B and E to the power C. So this is the equation. So this is the equation. So our main intention in this question is to find this A, B and C by using dimensional analysis, and when we get those values, we will get the relationship. So let's write the dimensional formula for different physical quantities given. Number one, time period. Time period itself is a base quantity. So what would be the dimensional quantity of time period? T power 1. Dimensional quantity will be T power 1. Next, K is constant. So K will not have any dimensions. Hence, no dimensional formula. Next term, pressure. Okay, the dimensional formula of pressure. Suppose if you don't know dimensional formula of any given physical quantity, then you should know at least any basic formula regarding that physical quantity, and by using that basic formula you can find the dimensional formula of that quantity. See here, pressure is defined as what? Force per unit area. Force is defined as what? Mass into acceleration divided by area. Okay, see, I don't know the dimensions of pressure. I don't know the dimension of pressure, nor I am going to remember the dimensions of the pressure. But I know the basic formula of pressure is what? Force per unit area. And I also know that force is equal to mass into acceleration. So the formula for pressure is what? Mass into acceleration by area. Now let me write, I know the dimensional formulas of mass, acceleration and area. Let me write the dimensional formula of those. What are the dimensional formula for mass? M to the power 1. What are the dimensional formula for acceleration? L power 1, T power minus 2. L power 1, T power minus 2. Okay. L power 1, T power minus 2. What are the dimensional formula of area? L power 2. Area is length into length. So, L power 2. So, what is the total dimensional formula?
How many m's are there? Only one. What is its power? 1. So m power 1. How many l's are there? 2 l's. What is its power? L power 1. And this l power 2 is in the denominator. If it comes to a numerator, it becomes minus 2. So it will be l power 1 minus 2. 1 minus 2. How much? Minus 1. And what about the time period? T. How many time periods are there? T. T only 1. T power minus 2. So this is the dimensional formula for pressure. So let me put it in a box so that you can identify it easily. Next to physical quantity, whose dimensions I need to find out? What is that? Density rho. So density rho, I don't know the dimensions. What formula I know about density? Density is equal to mass by volume. Mass by volume. What is the formula for mass? What is the formula for mass? I'm asking dimensional formula. M power 1. What is the dimensional formula for volume? Length into breadth into height. Length into length. So volume can be written as L power 3. So what is the dimensional formula for density? Rho is equal to M power 1 L power 3 in the denominator. L power 3 in the denominator goes to the numerator L power minus 3. So this is the dimensional formula for density. Next, what are we supposed to find out? We need to find the dimensional formula for the third quantity, energy. Okay, which formula do you know about energy? Energy, maybe potential energy. Potential energy is equal to mgh. Find the dimensions of m, g and h. Or you can use energy, right? You can write the formula of kinetic energy, half mv square. Write the dimensions of m and v. Okay, let me write that for you. E is equal to half mv square. I'm writing the dimensions of kinetic energy. So E, what are the dimensions of half? Half is a constant, so no dimensions. What is the dimensional formula for mass? Dimensional formula for mass is m power 1. What is the dimensional formula for velocity? Okay, velocity is what? Displacement by time taken. Displacement dimension, length. Time taken, t. T is in the denominator, comes to the numerator, t power minus 1. So L into t power minus 1. To the power 2, because square is there. So let's see. What is the dimension? How many m's are there? 1m. M power 1. How many l are there? 1l raised to the power 2. How many l's? 2l's. How many t's? T power minus 1. Whole power 2. So t power minus 2. So this is the dimensional formula for energy. Now we have all the dimensional formulae. Hence, we can start our dimensional analysis. So let me start the dimensional analysis for you. Okay. So remember, dimensional formula for T is T power 1. Okay. T power 1. Remember that. Now, let me write. So dimensional formula of T is what? T power 1. So dimensional formula of K is constant, no dimensional formula. Then dimensional formula of pressure, m power 1, l power minus 1, t power minus 2, whole power a. Correct? So pressure we have written. P power a, whole power a. Next, dimensional formula for density. What is the dimensional formula for density? M power 1. L power minus 3 raised to the power b. Okay, this is also we have written. And the third one, energy. What is the dimensional formula of energy? M power 1 L power 2 t power minus 2 whole power c. So we will find out a, b and c. So we'll get the relationship. Now see here t power 1, left side, come to the left hand side, t power 1. What is the dimension for mass here? Nothing is written. That means mass to the power 0. What is the dimension for length? L to the power 0. What is the dimension for time? T power 1. So this is my left hand side. Now carefully see my right hand side. Okay, so it's going to be very different now. Carefully see my right hand side. So right hand side, how many m's? First count how many m's. M1 is here, m2 is there, m3 is there. So m to the power 1 whole power a. So what is the power? Ma, m to the power a, correct, into m power 1 whole power b, that means m power b, into m power 1 whole power c, m power c. So m power a into m power b into m power c, what is this? M power a plus b plus c, correct. Next, now check length l power minus 1 to the whole power a. So l power minus a, l power minus 3 whole power b, l power minus 3b. Now l power 2 whole power c, so l power 2c. So l power minus a into l power minus 3b into l power minus l power plus 2c. Clear? So how can I write this? L power minus a, l power minus 3b, l power plus 2c. So this is the power of l, right? Let's write for time. How many times? Where are the time here? Here, only two terms. T power minus 2 whole power a. So t power minus 2a. T power minus 2a. T power minus 2 whole power c. T power minus 2c. So t power minus 2a into t power minus 2c. T power minus 2a minus 2c. So this is my right hand side. Left hand side, right hand side. So this formula is, if this formula is correct, then it will also be dimensionally correct. Okay, if the formula is correct, that means it should also be dimensionally correct. If the equation has to be dimensionally correct, then the powers of m on both sides should be equal, powers of l on both sides should be equal, powers of time on both sides should be equal. So let's equate them. So first, a, see there, m power 0, m power a plus b plus c, that means a plus b plus c should be equal to 0. This is my equation number 1. Now let's see for length, l power 0. So what is here on the right hand side? L power minus a minus 3b plus 2c should be equal to the power on the left hand side. What is the power on the left hand side? 0. Equation 2. Now third, t is equal to t power minus 2a minus 2c should be equal to how much? T power 1, 1. So minus 2a minus 2c should be equal to 1. So these are the three equations, three unknowns, three equations. Hence, if we solve these three equations, we can get the relationship. Okay. So next thing, steps which I am doing, it's on you. Okay, next steps which I am doing, it's on you. Whatever you find, whichever way you find easy, please do that way. Okay, please do that way. See how I am doing now. Here I have a relationship between A and C. Okay, here I have between ABC, ABC. So what I will do? I will do something with equation 1 and 2 such that I can eliminate B. Okay, I'll do an operation between 1 and 2 such that B will get eliminated. So what is that operation? See here. So these are my equations. What is the operation? See here. If I multiply equation number 1 into 3, equation number 1 into 3, and if I add it with equation number 2, what I am going to get? Equation 1 into 3, that means this 3 times, this into 3, 3 times, okay, that is 3 times. So if I multiply with 3 times, how much? 3a plus 3b plus 3c is equal to 3 into 0. How much? 0. Right? Now 1 into 3 over plus equation 2. Just write the equation 2. Minus 3b plus 2c equal to 0. Add them. Plus 3a minus a. How much? 2a. 3 plus 3b minus 3b. 0. 3c plus 2c. How much? 5c is equal to 0. Now I got a relationship, right? A and c. Now you see, let me write this as equation number 4. Equation number 4. So, equation number 4. Okay, equation number 4 I got. Now, by using equation number 4 and equation number 3, let us solve. See here, if I add 3 and 4, if I add 3 and 4, A will get eliminated. So let me write that. Okay, let me write it. So what I am doing, I am adding 3 and 4. I am adding equation 3 plus equation 4. So what is equation 3? This is equation 3. Minus 2a minus 2c is equal to 1. What is equation 4? Plus 2a plus 5c is equal to 0. So add it. Add this. Minus 2a plus 2a, 0. Minus 2c plus 5c, 3c is equal to 1. So what is the formula for c? C is equal to 1 by 3. So I got 1. Okay, one constant, I got one constant, that is c is equal to 1 by 3. Okay, c is equal to 1 by 3. C is equal to 1 by 3. Okay, c is equal to 1 by 3. By using c is equal to 1 by 3, can I get a? Okay, which formula you can? You can use equation 3, or you can use equation 4. Any formula, any equation you use. Let me use equation 4. So what is equation 4? Equation 4 is 2a plus 5c is equal to 0. So a is equal to how much? 5c goes there, minus 5c. Right, and 2a is equal to 5c, so a is equal to minus 5 by 2 c. A is equal to minus 5 by 2 c. So if I put the value of c as 1 by 3, how much I am getting? Minus 5 by 2 into 1 by 3, so it is minus 5 by 6. Now I have got a value also. A is equal to minus 5 by 6. Now what is left? Only, okay, now what is left? Only b is left. So which equation? Let us use the simplest equation, a plus b plus c equal to 0. Okay, so let me write the equation a plus b plus c is equal to 0. So what is the value of a? Minus 5 by 6. What is the value of b? We have to find out. What is the value of c? C 1 by 3 equal to 0. So b is equal to minus 5 by 6 goes there, plus 5 by 6. 1 by 3 goes there, minus 1 by 3. LCM 6. 6 and 3 LCM 6. So 5 ones are and 3 twos are. So 1 twos are. So it is 5 minus 2. 5 minus 2. 3 by 6. 1 by 2. So B value is 1 by 2. Okay. B value is 1 by 2. So we also got B 1 by 2. Clear? So up to getting this equation, after getting this equation, everything is mathematics part. Okay? The mathematics part. So we got the values A, B, and C. So let's get the relationship. Okay? So let us get the relationship. So what is the relationship? T is equal to K into P power A. What is pressure to the power? How much? pressure to the power minus 5 by 6. Then density to the power b, density to the power what is b? 1 by 2. Okay. Next, energy to the power 1 by 3. Energy to the power 1 by 3. So this is the relationship. Okay. This is the relationship. Okay. Initially, we didn't know how they are related to each other. Now I know time period is related to minus 5, p to the power minus 5 by 6. Time period is related to density as time period equal to square root of density. Time period relation with energy, time period is a cube root of energy.
So I suppose you have understood this question. If you have any doubts or any problem, you can comment me. Okay, thank you.